Good day, people of YouTube. What's going on? The name is AK, owner of Extreme Edge Productions, and today I bring you yet another XTalk video presentation. And before I begin, I'd just like to say, like, if the audio quality does sound a bit weird, that's because I'm actually using the microphone in my smartphone to record, because my normal USB microphone seems to have died on me randomly, so I had to use this as a makeshift, but I've done some tests already in Audacity, and it does seem to be pretty okay, so please, I hope you understand if the quality does sound a bit weird. But anyway, let's get into the main discussion. So as the title says, what we're going to be talking about today is the future of microtransactions and loot boxes. And this whole situation, of course, stems from the massive fiasco which was brought up over Battlefront 2, Star Wars Battlefront 2, an EA game, and the gaming community really clapped back hard on EA over implementing loot boxes and microtransactions into the game, and this resulted in EA basically doing a half 180. And the reason why I say a half 180, I'm gonna get to in a bit, but let's just look at the timeline here. So just a few weeks ago, you know, the fan reaction really became very, very loud, and that forced EA to make a bit of changes. They decided to tweak the system, the microtransaction system, to make the prices fairer and to make those who aren't paying, those who are just grinding to get the same rewards, they reduced the amount of time that it would take to get those rewards. That was the first change. But then people weren't happy. People said that EA, you just need to take it out completely. And so finally, after enough pushing, EA did decide to turn off the Switch. They turned off all microtransactions, turned off all loot boxes in the game. They were completely removed. And they released a statement saying that they will be reviewing the system and they will make changes and then it will come back at a later date, but for now, it has been disabled. And that right there is the catch. Despite all of the bad PR that this has resulted in, despite the huge fan backlash, despite even mainstream media like CNN picking up the story and turning it into a topic of, is loot boxes trying to introduce gambling to children? With Belgium even going as far as to want to ban loot boxes completely because they consider it to be gambling. This whole situation has really been bad for EA. It's really made the company look very bad, very, very bad. But yet, despite all of that, it's still standing by its statement that it will review the microtransaction system in Battlefront 2 and that it will implement it at a later date. They never said they're going to turn it off completely. They never said it's going to be taken out forever. This is just temporary. And it goes to show you what the goal of that these companies are going for when it comes to having these microtransactions and loot boxes in these games anyway. Their goal is to make as much revenue from repeated purchases. That is all that they are looking for. You know, with standard, you know, a standard $60 game, you pay for the game and that's it. If the game gets DLC, that's probably going to be some additional revenue. But with microtransactions, you have this consistent source of revenue because these are small purchases, you know, $1, $2, $3. Some people, like, when they see those tiny little prices, they're like, oh, I'll just throw $3 in the game. And then they just keep doing it and they keep doing it. They keep doing it because it's such a small fee that they're not really thinking about it. Now, if that $3 were to turn into $30, like it is, you know, like for some DLC packs, they can cost like $20, for example, people are going to say, well, oh, I'm not paying that much for new content. Like, I could spend that money on a whole other game. Like, why would I pay that much for DLC? But with microtransactions, that's why they're called microtransactions. You have those small little purchases, and it's a psychology thing. And I've talked about this before. But when it comes down to the future of it, even after, you know, we have all this bad PR, when microtransactions and loot boxes look like the devil, despite that, EA is still standing by it. And there are other titles right now that were released this year recently that also have microtransactions, and some of them are other EA games like FIFA 18, for example, and Need for Speed Payback, just to name a few. So microtransactions are still there in other titles. It's just that Battlefront 2 got the brunt of all the bad PR. But eventually the topic is going, as it is always the case, the topic is going to go away, discussion is going to die down, the heat is going to come off of EA. And whenever that happens, that's most likely when the company's just going to flip the switch again, and microtransactions and loot boxes will be put back into Battlefront 2. And at that point, they might probably have all the sales that they need, because, I mean, it's a Star Wars product. Star Wars is one of the biggest names in all of entertainment. Of course it's going to sell. And what you have to realize is that when it comes down to sales, like the overall sales, the demographic, there are two separate categories. There are casual consumers and then the gaming enthusiasts. The gaming enthusiasts are the people who are going to come to YouTube and watch a video like this, a gaming discussion video. They're going to go onto sites like IGN and other media websites looking for gaming news. They are the ones who went after EA over this. They are the ones who went on Reddit during that AMA and downvoted that comment, making it the most downvoted comment in Reddit history, that when EA was trying to defend the whole microtransaction. All right, that was the work of the enthusiasts. The casual consumers, on the other hand, they're the ones who just buy games and play them because they think they're fun, and that's it. They just see it as another source of entertainment, just like how they like music, just how they go to the movies to watch a movie because they want to see the movie. You know, they're not invested in the activity. They just like the product. That's it, all right? They play the game for a few hours, and their relationship with that game doesn't go any further than that. They don't really call themselves a fan. They just enjoy the game. And in most cases, that is what you have with gaming. I mean, really, you have that in any hobby. You have movie enthusiasts, and then you have people who just watch movies. You have music enthusiasts and people who just listen to music. You have writing enthusiasts, and then you have people who just like to read books. And then you have gaming enthusiasts and people who just like to play games. They are, in all these instances, we have these two separate categories. And in most cases, the enthusiasts are always outnumbered by the casuals. Always. And at the end of the day, as long as that's the case when it comes to gaming specifically, then these companies are just going to continue their money-hungry practices, okay? They don't care about you as a person. They don't care if you think that this is some type of anti-consumer practice. All they want is to make sure that their bottom dollar stays high. They just want to make as much revenue as possible. And if that means turning your $60 purchase into an additional $200, they are happy with that. And if just your instance, like let's just say you do invest $200 extra into that game, multiply that by, let's say, 1,000 people, you can easily see how much more profit that they're making versus just releasing a game for $60. That is why that they're after these microtransactions and loot boxes. That's why they're implementing them wherever they can, because they see it as a big sea of green, which is what it is. And as long as that's the case, they are going to continue pushing for it. These things are not going to go away, all right? Some gamers see this as being a victory that they were able to take down EA. And EA did not reverse its decision. EA is delaying its decision. It didn't change it. It's only delaying it, all right? You didn't change EA's mind. Like, the top executives who asked the developers to put that microtransaction system in the game in the first place, those top executives, they didn't suddenly have a change of heart when all this backlash came their way and they decided to trying to atone for their sins by telling the developers, okay, turn it off, take it out. No, the only reason that this happened was because they didn't want all that bad publicity on them, because it was making them look bad, and they probably thought it was going to be a threat to their profits. And that's the only reason why the decision was made to take out microtransactions for the time being. But as soon as the heat cools off, they're going to be put right back in. And like I said, we have other EA titles that still have microtransactions enabled, such as FIFA and Need for Speed, and other titles from other big companies like NBA 2K18 from Take-Two. That's a game that's full with microtransactions, and there was people who were upset about that, but Take-Two, sorry, never took it out. So you see what I mean? These companies, they're going to look for any which way to implement these microtransactions, and as long as it's not going to affect their profits negatively, they will continue to keep them in there. Like, these systems, regardless of how anti-consumer you think it is, these companies do not care. They don't care about your opinion. All they want is your money. And as long as you throwing a hissy fit isn't going to get in the way of them getting money, then they don't care. They really don't care. All right? EA is not atoning for its sins. It's only appeasing the masses to try and look a little bit better. That's all. You can fundamentally compare this situation to that of a spouse walking into their partner cheating on them. All right? You have three questions to ask. Why is the partner cheating? How long has this been going on? Was this just like a moment of weakness, or was this like a repeated offense? Like, has this been happening for quite a while? And third, if, you know, the partner who's cheating is seeking to apologize, they want to apologize, they want to restart, you know, the whole thing, you know, like, you know, I want to be better and this isn't going to happen again and blah, blah, blah. In that situation, is that partner who cheated trying to ask for forgiveness because they're genuinely sorry for what they did, or is it because they just got caught? Like, if they didn't get caught, would they feel bad about it? That is the question that really comes up. And you can apply this exact same questions to companies like EA who are putting in these microtransactions. Those who are doing a 180 with their decisions, like what EA did, are they doing it because they feel bad, or are they doing it because they got caught? In EA's case, I've already established they're only doing this. They're only trying to look good because they got caught. If they didn't get caught, or if only a small amount of people just got upset about it, then EA was still going to keep the microtransactions inside Battlefront 2. Like, it was never going to be disabled in the first place. It was going to stay exactly how it was before, even before the tweaks. They weren't even going to bother making tweaks if they didn't get caught, only because they got caught. And that is when you know whether or not someone's being genuine. Like, are they doing this because they have to, or are they doing this because they want to? EA is doing this because they have to, not because they want to. And as soon, like I said, as soon as that heat comes off, they're going to flip the switch and they're just going to go right back to how it was before. So microtransactions will be here to stay as long as people keep buying them. As long as companies see it as a viable profit source, they are going to stick around. They're never going to leave, as long as that's the case. Leave your comments down below. Tell me what you think about this topic. And also, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you didn't like it, give it a thumbs down and tell me how I can improve the quality of the content. But until next time, I hope you enjoy yourself and hope to see you in the next video.